So well students, in our previous class we have studied about lines and angles, and also we proved a theorem: vertically opposite angles are equal when two lines are intersected. And also we proved another theorem: a corresponding angle in a parallel line when transversal is intersected that are equal. So in this class we are going to study about lines parallel to the same lines. Lines parallel to the same lines, which means observe here is a line. Call this line as AB. AB is one line, and CD, it is the CD, another line. Now AB is parallel to CD. AB is parallel to CD. Draw one more line which is parallel to CD. Call it as EF. Now CD parallel to EF. How many lines, straight lines are here? It has three lines. Now you can draw a transversal like this. Call it as PQRST. So PT is a transversal. PT is a transversal. It intersects AB at Q, CD at R, EF at S. Therefore, so AB parallel to CD, CD parallel to EF. How many lines are parallel here? Three lines are parallel. Three lines are parallel. So now remember, any number of lines admitted. So one is parallel to other, another is parallel to other. First line is parallel to the next line is parallel to the other line. It means AB parallel to CD, CD parallel to EF, AB parallel to EF also. EF also. That can be proved in a theorem. So write down the theorem statement. Observe carefully. End of the theorem. Yes. What does the theorem say? Lines. Theorem. Lines which are parallel to the lines which are parallel to the same line. Same line are parallel to each other. Are parallel to each other. Now here is a statement: lines which are parallel to same line are parallel to each other. So we have to prove this theorem. Any number of parallel lines are one. So one is parallel to other, another one is parallel to the next one. Draw a line, as you all know, just now you already know. Call this line is AB, and another line call it as CD. Now many lines are here? Two lines. AB parallel to CD, that is called as a data. Data AB parallel to CD. AB parallel to CD. Draw one more line. Call it as EF. Call it as EF. Let us say CD parallel to EF. AB parallel to CD. Lines which are parallel to same lines are parallel to each other. One is parallel to other. Means AB is parallel to CD. CD is parallel to EF. CD is parallel to EF. Now let us draw a line. Call it as a transversal. Call it as P and Q, R, S, T. PT is a transversal. PT is a, yes, PT is a transversal. It intersects AB at Q, CD at R, EF at S. To show that R, prove AB parallel. प्रूव
Y angle, this angle in target. Very interesting.
So observe here, PQ is a straight line. PQ is a straight line, of course. So sum of this triangle is 180 degree. 180 degree. 180 degree. Now here also you can get 180 degree. It means VXY angle and MYS angle very easily you can calculate. But you can't get XMY angle. For that, what we have to do? Draw a line like this which passes through M. Call this as A. Call this as AB. So in solution, what they are given? Observe here. MXQ is 135 degrees given, and MYR angle, MYR angle is given, which is 40 degrees. Now, to find what we have to find? We have to find XMY angle. For that, construction. Just like a theorem also, you can work out this step. Draw AB line, AB line. So throw M, that is AB parallel to PQ, parallel to RS. It means draw a line AB, that line is parallel to PQ, that line is parallel to RS. So now come to the proof or findings. So observe here, we draw AB line which is parallel to PQ. It means observe here, so this angle and this angle, sum of these angle is 180 degree. How? What type of angles these two? These two are interior angles on the same side of a transversal. Therefore, QXM angle plus XMB angle, XMB angle is equal to 180 degree. The reason is interior pair of interior angles on the same side of a transversal. Interior angles on the same side of a transversal. Interior angles on the same side of a transversal is how much degree? 180 degree. Okay. But yes, QXM is given, it is 135. In the case of QMX angle, 135 degree plus XMB is equal to 180 degree. Now find XMB angle. Therefore XMB angle is equal to 180 minus 135. So the difference of these two, 10 minus 5 is 5, here remaining 7. So yes, 7 minus 3 is 7 minus 3 is 4 and 1 minus 1 is 0. Therefore, XMB is how much degree? 45 degree. XMB is 45 degree. And MBY angle, observe it, MBY, this angle is equal to MYR angle. BMY angle is equal to MYR. How these two are equal? Yes, these two are alternate angles because AM parallel to RS. If AM parallel to RS, BMY is equal to MYR. These two are alternate angles. Alternate angles are equal. Finally, you can find XMY angle. XMY y is nothing but xmv, xmv plus bmy, bmy. xmv is how much degree? xmv. Here you have calculated xmv, which is 45 degree, plus bmy. bmy is 40 degree. Therefore, sum of these two is 85 degree. Therefore, xmy is 85 degree. Once again, look here. mx q is 135 degree. MYR is 40 degree. You can find XMY angle, sum of the two angle. Directly it is not possible. That's why you can go far. So, line AB line we draw, which is parallel to PQ and which is parallel to RS, like that you can draw another line. So, in between these two lines, it will pass through M. Like that we can draw a line. Now as for this diagram is concerned, so xqxm angle plus xmq angle, sum of these two angles is 180 degree, because the two are interior angles on the same side of a transversal. That sum is 180 degree. Therefore, 180 minus 135 is 45 degree. This angle is not 45 degree. And also observe that this exact shape, that is an alternate angle. So MYR is 40, BMY is also 40. That one you can calculate. 40 plus 45 is 85 degree, that is XMY. Like this you can find XMY angle. XMY angle. Without construction directly it is not possible. The next question. Yes. Now
transversal intersect two lines such that bisectors of A pair of corresponding angles pair of corresponding angles are parallel. Then prove that the two lines are parallel. Remember this statement? It's like a theorem. If your transversal intersect two lines, the bisector pair of corresponding angles means transversal means a line, two lines. How many lines here? Two lines. So name it as PQ and RS. Call it as PQ, one line, and RS, another line. PQ parallel to RS and a transversal. You can draw like this also. If this transversal is, call it as A, S, B, C, D is a transversal. Now draw bisectors. So like this and like this. Call the name it as S, E and G. You can give any name, E and G. Now, if a transversal intersect, which is the transversal? AB is a transversal. Intersect two lines. Which are the lines? PQ and RS. Two lines. Bisector of pair of corresponding angle. Bisector means, observe here, B bisect ABQ means these two are equal. And CG bisect BCS, these two are equal bisectors. Okay? So, prove that direct lines are parallel. Direct lines means, so you can prove that PQ parallel to RS. But what is given? What is given here? Yes, if a transversal intersect two lines such that bisector of pair of corresponding angles, pair of corresponding angles means given BE is parallel to CG. They are given BE is parallel to CG. Show that, you have to show that. To show that, yes, PQ parallel to RS. Very interesting one. What they are given? Bisector lines are parallel. You have to show that remaining PQ and RS are parallel. Now come to the proof. Here construction is not necessary. Observe here. A, B, Q angle is divided by a B line into two equal parts because BE is a bisector line. BE is a bisector line. Therefore, ABE angle, ABE angle is always half of ABQ angle. ABQ angle because BE is a bisector. ABE is always half of the ABQ. ABQ, call this as 1. And also BCG. BCG is equal to half of BCS. BCS. Because CG is a bisector. It divides the total angle into two equal parts. Therefore, half of that angle is always BCG is half of the total angle. BCG is half of the total angle. Call this as 2. Call this as 2. We know that BE parallel to CG. BE parallel to CG because that is given. If BE parallel to CG, ABE angle is equal to BCG angle. ABE angle, therefore, ABE angle is equal to, yes, BCG angle. BCG angle, these are corresponding angles in a parallel line. What are these? These are corresponding angles in a parallel line because BE parallel to CG, ABE is equal to BCG. So ABE from 1, ABE means what? Half into ABQ. Half into ABQ. You have to substitute. ABE is always half of ABQ, which is equal to, what is BCG? BCG means half of BCS. Half of BCS. Okay? ABE is half ABQ. BCG is half BCS. Half and half cancel. So ABQ is equal to BCS. Observe here. from the figure we got ABQ is equal to BC. Yes, ABQ means this angle is equal to this angle. From the figure, by observing these two are equal. Now what type of angles? So corresponding angles. Therefore, PQ parallel to RS. PQ parallel to RS because corresponding angles are equal. We can say that the two angles are corresponding angles and the two angles are equal. Then we can say that PQ parallel to RS. Once again, look here. BE parallel to CG, they are given. BE parallel to CG. If BE parallel to CG, we know that ABE is equal to EBQ and BCG is equal to CGCS. Therefore, to show that BE parallel to RS, the two lines are so parallel to each other. Now, in proof, you can consider ABE angle. From the figure, BE is a bisector line. That line divides the angle into two equal parts. Therefore, ABE so is always half of total angle. That is ABQ. Call this as one. And also, BCG is always equal to half of BCS. So now we know that we are given BE is equal to CG. If BE and CG are equal, bisector lines are equal, ABE is equal to BCG, that are corresponding angles. Substitute ABE is equal to half ABQ and substitute BCG is equal to half BCS, half and half on both sides it will be cancelled. So ABQ is equal to BCS. Therefore, PQ parallel to RS like this. So we can do the statement. The next question. Yes. Yes. Take out that one. In the figure, find the values of x and y and then show that AB parallel to CD. Now here is the diagram. A line parallel to another line. First line is AB and the second line is CD and a transversal. So it is. So here this angle is given 50 degree. This angle is x and this angle is y. This angle is 130 degree. Now from the figure, find the values of x and y. So by observing the diagram, we can find x and y. Show that A B parallel to CD. How to find x value? Now observe the lines AB and another line. Let us say P, Q, R, S. That is RS. PQ and RS. PQ, RS or PS transversal intersect AB at Q. So what type of these two angles? So PQ, that is a transversal. In the figure, it looks like a transversal. This is 50 degree. So 50 degree plus S is equal to 180 degree. How? These two are linear pair of angles. Linear pair of angles. Sum is 180 degree. Sum is 180 degree. Therefore, x is equal to 180 minus 50. So, x is equal to the difference of these two. 10 minus 0. 0 minus 0, 0. 8 minus 5. 8 minus 5, 3. 1. So x is 130 degree. We got x value 130 degree. Okay. Find y value. Find y value. How to find y value? Yes. How to find y value? Observe here. RS. RS. PQRS is a line. And CP is another line. Observe these two angles. What type of these two angles? So y is equal to 130. Because are vertically opposite angles. So y is equal to 130. Vertically opposite angles. Therefore, so here, therefore we can say that x is equal to y is equal to 130. X is also 130. Y is also 130. It means this is 130 degree. This is also 130 degree. Observe. What type of angles? Alternate angles are equal. Alternate angles are equal. If alternate angles are equal, we can say that AB is parallel to CD. AB is parallel to CD. So in this way, we can find x and y. We got x value